Welcome to Understand the Math. In this problem, we're given that t of x1, x2 is equal to the vector 2x1 and then 4x2 plus 3. And we're asked to determine if this transformation is a linear transformation. Let's start by understanding what a linear transformation is. T of x will be a linear transformation if T of x can be written as a matrix A times a vector x. So what we're going to do to solve this problem is we're going to check if T of x can be written as A times x. It's going to be really helpful if we start by taking our transformation and writing it as a vector. So let's go ahead and let's do that. So we have T of our vector x1, x2 is going to be equal to the vector. And before we do this, let's notice that we have one comma. That comma tells us that we're going to have two components and it separates those two components. So our first component is going to be 2x1, and then our second component is going to be 4x2 plus 3. Our goal is to see if we can write this as A times x. So what we're going to do is let's pull this apart and try to write it as a matrix A times a vector x. I think an in-between step that will help is if we go ahead and write this. So let's write 2x1, and then there's no x2s, so let's write this as 0x2. And then in our second component, there are no x1s, so let's write 0x1 plus 4x2 plus 3. And that will really help us to determine what A is going to look like. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a matrix A that multiplies x1, x2. When we look back at this matrix, we can see that our A is going to be 2, 0, 0, 4. And then we have this extra component. So what we're going to do with that component is we're going to have to add on a vector 0, 3. So our transformation is A times x, but it's not just equal to A times x because we have this extra vector, which we can just call vector p. So we can say that our transformation is not equal to A times x because of this additional vector p. So because of this, our answer is going to be no, our transformation is not a linear transformation. The other thing that we could have looked at is we could have seen what t of 0 is. So if a transformation is linear, the idea is that the origin remains fixed. So t of 0 should be equal to 0. When we come up here, and if we were to plug in that x1 and x2 was equal to 0, you can see that t of 0 is equal to 0, 3, and it's not equal to 0. So the idea is that the origin does not remain fixed, which means that this is not a linear transformation.
If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.